Hello guys, so in this video I want us to go through how we can set up and configure VLAN in our MikroTik routers. So basically what I have here is a MikroTik router, and we are going to add different devices to it so that we can configure the VLANs, so that we can also be able to see how the different IPs of the separate VLANs will be assigned to each and every user. So basically we can set up maybe a few devices. So let me start adding a few devices that will be connected to this MikroTik router that I have. I'm going to add another MikroTik there. I'm going to add maybe a third MikroTik, and maybe just I'm going to add also a PC. So for this video we are going to set up maybe three VLAN for our main MikroTik router. So maybe we can just add a few notes over here such that we give them the different IPs. So we have we are going to have VLAN 10, VLAN 10, of which we are going to use 172.10.10.1/24. Then we are going to have VLAN 20, which we are going to use 172.20.20.1/24, and maybe we can just add another VLAN, maybe VLAN 30, which we are going to use 172.30.30.1/24. So those are the IPs that we are going to use for the separate VLANs that we have. So let's start by now connecting these devices to our core MikroTik router here. Maybe we can rename this and say maybe this is our core. Apply. Yep. So let's connect these devices. Let's link them up. So Ether 2 is going to go to, let's say, Ether 0. Then Ether 3 is going to go to Ether 0 here as well. Ether 4 is going to go to Ether 0 of the PC. So basically that is how it's set up. So the next thing we need to do is we need to log in into our MikroTik router and now start the configuration. So I'm going to log into that MikroTik through Winbox. As you can see here it is. The board is CHR. This is a cloud hosted router. And the configuration that I'm going to do, this is going to work similarly as it would if you do the same configuration on just a physical router that you have with you. So we log in. It's going to ask us to input a new password for change. So as it is, we are already inside our core MikroTik router. We can come and maybe set the identity here to core as well. Okay, so we need to maybe make a bridge of some of these networks that we are going to use. Or even if you wouldn't want to make a bridge, because this, as you can see, our devices are connected to different ports. So okay, for now let's not make the bridge. What we will now need to do is to create the VLAN, come to the interface, come to VLAN and add. So this is going to be VLAN 10. The VLAN ID is going to be 10, and this is going to be on Ether. Let's come back to our diagram again. So we want this to be this MikroTik 2 over here to get its IP from VLAN 10, and as you can see, it's connected on Ether. This is definitely the third port. Okay, we go back to our Winbox. This is Ether 3. Because we have Ether 1 and Ether 2 have been taken by our, let me show you, Ether 1 and Ether 2 have been taken by our cloud and our NAT. I'll give an explanation of that maybe sometime later on. So this is connected to Ether 3. So the interface is going to be Ether 3. Apply. Okay. Then we add the next one. Let's say this is going to be VLAN 20. The ID is going to be 20. And the interface is going to be 1, 2, 3. It's going to be 4. Apply. Okay. We come to the next, which is going to be VLAN 30. The interface is, the VLAN ID is going to be 30. And the interface is going to be 1, 2, 3, 4. It's going to be 5. Apply. Okay. So we now have, okay, see there's an error here. Let's rectify this. This should be 10. Apply. Okay, so we've now added our VLANs on our core MikroTik router. So the next thing that we need to do is we need to assign the IPs that we said right here. This, we need to assign these IP addresses to those VLAN IDs. So the next thing that you need to do, you come to IP address, then add. Our first IP is going to be 172.10.10.1/24, and this is going to be on Ether 3. Apply. Okay. We need to add the second one, which is going to be 172.20.20.1/24. This is going to be on Ether 4. Apply. Okay. Then we need to add the last one, which is going to be 172.30.30.1/24. And this is going to be on Ether 5. Apply. Okay. So the next thing that we now need to do is we need now to configure our DHCP server. So you come to IP, DHCP server, then DHCP setup. We're going to assign that to interface 3. Next, the IP is 172.10.10.0. That is the address space. Everything, the DHCP network looks good. The address range also looks good, because now this is going to be the IP pool that this device are going to be pulling from. So next, maybe we can change this to 8.8.8. Next, list time is 10, that's okay. And setup is complete for the first one. We need to set up the second one. Okay, just a DHCP setup. We need to set this up for Ether 4. Next, everything looks great. Next, finish. The last one, setup. This one goes to Ether 5. Next. Okay, we are now done. So after doing this configuration, our devices down here, these devices should now receive the different IPs that we've created for the VLANs that they are connected to. So what we now need to do to confirm the same, we now need to log into these devices individually so that we can be able to see the IP addresses that they have been given. So to log into this MikroTik over here through Winbox, GNS3 has provided, and MikroTik per se, that is, has provided a protocol that we can use to connect to it through GNS, through GNS3, and that is Roman. So what we need to do is we need to activate Roman for this device, and also for our core router we need to enable Roman. So for our first core machine router, that is, all we need to do is come to Tools, Roman, Enable, okay, that's it. So for this, we first of all need to get into it using the console. So we'll come to the console, web console. The default login address for MikroTik is admin. The password is blank. You'll say yes for Y. Then it will ask you to input a new password. 1, 2, 3, 4. Not an advisable password, but for demonstration purposes. 1, 2, 3, 4. Enter. So as it is now, we are inside that MikroTik router. We want to enable Roman so that we can be able to log into it using MikroTik. So to enable Roman through the console, what you need to do is just say tool Roman enable tool Roman set enable, yes. And it's set. We can also maybe give it a name by saying like system identity set name. Maybe we can say tick. Just for demonstration, that's it. So we also need to enable Roman for the third MikroTik, which is this. So we also need just to come and click on it, right click and open the web console. And good thing about GNS is that the web console will just keep opening on one page and different slides, as you can see here. So it's admin, enter, no password for now, yes. It will prompt you to input a new password. We'll also do 1, 2, 3, 4. We do the same to activate Roman. So we say tool Roman. No. Set enable, yes, enter. let's change the ID. We are going to say system identity set name. Maybe we are going to say tick 3. Enter. So for these two MikroTik routers over here, we are now able to log into them through Winbox. So what we need to do is we need to come to our first MikroTik router, which is the core MikroTik router we had. Then come and open a new Winbox. And now for you to get access to the two other MikroTiks that we had, you now need to come and say connect to Roman. Our password for that MikroTik was also 1234. Then you say connect to Roman. So we are now going to see the Roman neighbors. We can see tick 2, we can see tick 3. So let's log into them. The password is the same. Okay, that is tick 2. And we now need to come to IP, because now this is going to be a DHCP client address. And you can see now it has been given the IP of 10.172.10.10.20.254, that is. Let's see the IP address that has been given to the next MikroTik router that we have. More Winbox. Let's connect to Roman. And tick 3, there it is. Then connect. Then we also need to come and check the IP. DHCP client. Yeah, and you can see that it also now has an IP of 10.20.20. That's the IP for that. And this is also, no, that is our core. Just a minute. IP address. And you can now be able to see that the IP addresses are different because of the VLAN configuration that we have done to our core MikroTik router. So that is how you do the configuration for the MikroTik. And we can also maybe check for the PC. We also will also access the PC through the console. So we'd come and say, right click, open web console. And we're already inside our PC. So what we need to do is configure the PC such that it's also able to receive an IP, that is an IP DHCP client. So how you do this from GNS console, what you need to do is just say IP DHCP, enter, and now it's now going to search for an IP, and you can see it has an IP of 172.30.30.254. So guys, as you can see, these are three different devices connected to one router, and VLAN is configured, and you can now be able to see that they have different IP addresses. Maybe in our next lesson we are going to go deeper into VLAN, where we will now talk about trunking, VLAN trunking. We are also going to talk about management and stuff like that. So for now, we'll end the video from there. Please guys, be sure to like, subscribe, and leave a comment so that I can also be able to know what you think of my videos and what you need me to do next. So guys, from me, it's goodbye. See you next time.